G'day guys, welcome to the channel. No intro today, thought to get straight into the 2024 Omega Speedmaster, first Omega in space hands-on. Now my brother picked this up recently actually, exactly a week after it was announced on the 3rd of October. He put his name down and basically got the call straight away. Now, the estimated wait time is about 6 months or so, so I think that we just got lucky when we ended up going. Now, everything about this watch is completely different to the normal Speedmaster Professional. So the diameter is listed at 39.7 millimeters, yet it doesn't look any smaller than 40, 41 millimeters in person, in my opinion. Now, the bracelet is also different and the lug to lug is also different at 48 millimeters. Thickness is slightly bigger at 13.4 millimeters, where the normal is at 13.2. Now, something to keep in mind is the legibility on the first Omega Espace is actually not that great. As you can see from the videos here, I'm trying to shoot it in direct sunlight just so you can see what it'll look like on your day-to-day. And it's not really the most legible thing. It is more of a dressy piece, because there's a lot of polished surfaces on it. Like, seeing this watch on my brother's wrist, I do get a lot of more dressy vibes from it. The piece does wear beautifully, and on my brother's massive 7.5+ inch wrist, it sits really, really well. And even on my small 6.5 inch wrist, it doesn't fit too badly. Now, in non-direct lighting, it is a pain to kind of see through the glass. Now, the glass is one of the main attractions because it mimics Hess light, but uses a sapphire. But as you can see, it does catch a lot of reflections, and that's not even my camera like bugging out. It is just actual watch itself catching a lot of reflections. Now, I got a few comments on my shorts video when we first inspected this watch, and as you can see on my 6.5 inch wrist, the watch doesn't wear big, but the lug to lug is a lot bigger. Well, not a lot bigger, but it's 1 millimeter bigger than the Moonwatch Professional, and the lugs flare straight out. So as you can see, there's a lot more of a substantial presence. Now, on the shorts video that I released, there were a lot of comments saying the legibility sucks. I'm here to say to you that, look, it's not the worst thing in the world in person. However, from the video capturing it, it doesn't look legible to you in the video. It's not gonna be the most legible thing in person. And some wrist shots here, it does fit well on my 6.5 inch wrist. So for those cross-shopping the normal Moonwatch Professional in this, I reckon give it a try. Though I do currently own the white Speedy, as you can see here. I wanted to do a comparison in the same video of how this wears versus the first Omega in space. And if you don't have a Speedy, I think you'd be happier with the normal Moonwatch Professional. Now, the bracelets I feel like is better on the normal Speedy. The lug to lug is more manageable because it's a millimeter shorter, right? It wears more compactly, and not only that, the lugs do curve downwards with the normal Speedy, whereas the first Omega in space, they are straight lugs. From a legibility perspective, the normal Moonwatch is a lot more legible. You don't have the blue-gray sunburst finish that's reflecting out. You got more of either the white or the straight black. And from a wearing perspective, look, I've done a comparison here. I feel like the normal Moonwatch fits better. But let's get back to face level to finish this video off and give you my final thoughts. Okay guys, so just to give you some closing thoughts, the first Omega in space, it is a nice piece. It is definitely worth the price of admission. However, I think that if you don't have a Speedy, I think you'd be happier with just going for a Moonwatch Professional. The first Omega in space, it is nice. Though the wearing experience for me when I put it on wrist, it feels a lot more dressy, so to speak. It's more flashy. The polished surface does give it that air of formal in a sense, even though it is a sports watch. And you know, from a day-to-day perspective and also just from a wearing perspective as well, I think the normal Moonwatch, either the black or white, doesn't matter. The normal Moonwatch would suit a lot more people. Now, is there room to have both the Professional and the first Omega in space in the same collection if you're made out of money? Sure, they both fit a certain, I guess, niche in a sense. They're both completely different from each other. You could own both in a collection, but from for variety's sake, I think you just probably choose one. Now, the lug to lug is something I want to make note of because it is longer than this. So in saying that, it's going to wear more broadly for a lot of people. The case diameter of 39.7 millimeters doesn't really tell the full story. As you can see in the videos on my brother's wrist, it does look very proportionate, but he's got massive wrist of over 7.5 inches. I think it's topping close to 8 inches in all honesty, but you know, for a majority of people, the 47 mil lug to lug from the normal Moonwatch is gonna feel a lot better. And final thoughts on it, it's a good watch. It is definitely worth a look. However, in terms of the hype around it, it isn't really the most hypest piece. Like, I don't think the hype is warranted. It is nice, I just don't think people should be paying resale for this piece, right? Like, this watch came out, people were, you know, selling it for resale. A lot of people got ripped off because now the hype's died down. It's going for under retail. Same thing with the First Omega in Space. It's not a above retail piece. It's a at retail or under type of watch, but it is nice. And I wouldn't get it myself. I already have this and I was considering getting it, but my brother got it now. So you can enjoy it. I can enjoy this and we can move on. That's the video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Catch you on the next one.